Hello everyone and welcome to the 8th completed settlement here in the old Megabuild series. Today we are at, well, Outpost Zimonja. We finally finished it up and we're going to take a look and see what we did. I did record, you know, the build of the house over there and the rest of the crap, but it turned out to be like 18 hours. It took me way too long to do this thing, and I know why, but I'll explain that in a minute. But first off, I wanted to give a shout out to Local 4-Pack. I want to show him the final map of my provision route. So this is what it looks like on the old Megabuild project. All my guys, everything's all connected now. It's all set up and ready to go. And so far I haven't had any problems with ghost routes or provisioners showing up where they shouldn't. It's weird that the Pridwin line changes to the ruins or the airport. It moves around a lot. But anyway, enough of that crap. Let's get this party started. So what happened was, the reason it took so long is because these mods, the settlement objects, there are so many of them that it takes forever to scroll through the menus. And I since there's so many of them, I forget where they are. And I don't know where to find what I placed. I didn't, you know, sometimes the one I want is like 80 objects deep. So I mean, I literally spent 25% of my time scrolling through menus. So I'm gonna have to figure something out. I have gotten the PC version and then the creation kit. I'm gonna play around with what I can do. Who knows what happens there. So, okay, so here's the entrance. This is, you know, where they come up, those turrets and that's the raider down there. So I figured at some point they drove up and they jackknife a truck up here. I don't know. Got my guard up there. He's chilling. He's like, hey man, missile turret. So when they come in, they have to enter this way and come around the corner. And, you know, got a dog there. He's ready to attack. One of my security guards
Farm's
here.
Not much, but it's something.
Yeah, it's something. It's punishment, dude. It's punishment. Okay, there's my my commandant. She's stuck inside the pen as she has been for a while. So they come up here and they go through the gate. Chain link fences. Got a lot of chain link fences. Yeah. This is open, so they've been wandering around. There's a lot of prisoners. Harness and a hood.
They ain't looking
and
for
she's
trouble,
got a harness man. And a shot collar on. And they're just basically locked in this little pen here. This is their little sleeping area with some, you know, snacks. They all sleep in bags. I couldn't sink them. I tried to sink them, but this surface wouldn't work for me. So here's the commandant. She's just hanging out in the pen with the prisoners for some reason. I don't know why. So come out here. I can't stop them from wandering for the most part. I mean, at night, they'll just wander around. You can't keep them in there. Let's go the tower. So here's the finished communications tower. Suitably scrappy. It's got some short up stuff down here. And we go up and we have the old communications place. Got some drinks out here. They like to hang out here and just, you know, look out at the camp. And then hope I don't make this too long, because building this thing up, it takes a while to go up and down. And so up here we have, you know, the bog standard work area with my folding chair and rolling tables and toolboxes. And I do like OCD. I do like the OC decorator. It's weird. It takes some getting used to. There's some oddities about it that I still have to figure out. I wish there was a way to make the default placement closer. It's like when you create an object, it puts it like 20 feet away and you always have to pull it in to place it. So go over here. I took the yellow chain link fence down, the outside one down, because I switched mods and I deleted the mod that I used for the chain link fences. So there's no chain link fences anymore out here. Basic workshop, more observation area. You can keep an eye on the prisoners there. And then here's the back of the original place, which I built freely up on. I was going to tear it down, but I'm like, you know what? I'm just going to do it. So another observation thing. And then a power door. So when they need medical attention, they go to the doctor really quick. The doctor's over there on the other side. Little seating area for the guards. They never use it because they're always on their guard stations. Little radio that I remember to turn off. And then the administrative office over here. We've got a little documentation in progress. Coffee cups everywhere. These people drink coffee like nobody's business. I don't know where they're getting the beans from, but they like coffee. So rugs in the sleeping area for the guards. The barracks, so to speak. More coffee. Some random storage crap under there. Another guard post here where they keep an eye on things. Pretty good sight lines. They don't lose track of the prisoners very often. Of course, you know, the prisoners are settlers. They don't really go anywhere anyway. But whatever. Come out the back here. And then this is a turret rack that I use because a lot of the attacks come over this hill. So having this thing here with the missile turrets is very handy. I'll give you a pan of the whole thing. So there's the commandant's house and the justice room. Tower. There's a guard walking around. And then the built-up area over where the original stuff used to be, which I didn't really change very much. With the mods, it does snap pretty good and clip pretty good, so it wasn't a problem. So here's the commandant's house. She shares it with the doctor. I'm going to show the doctor's place. So the doctor's underneath here, kind of tucked away underneath here. She doesn't need a lot. There's only like six people here, so whatever. Brotherhood of Steel. She's the person they assigned to this place.
For a small fee.
Basic beds, basic equipment. Got the arch underneath here. The workbench. So it's all pretty much tucked around and centered around this particular thing. So anyway, here's their house. It's slapped together. I figured since it was on the hill, I had to prop it up with those junk fences. And their eating area, little patio. And then the doctor's got her experimental area here, which, they've got a scanner and a whole computer and a console and a whole bunch of tools. I don't really want to know what kind of experiments they're doing with prisoners on their off time. I figure it's best not to ask. More coffee because, oh my God, they love coffee. Pile of crap they haven't put away yet. And then the official, I don't know, doctors and bunk room and the safe. And they've got, you know, all their crap sticking out everywhere. So let's go out here, go down here. There's the back. And then the justice room again. I'm starting to really like these big walls, the big tall ones. These are in the mod unlock settlement objects thing. I'm really liking these. They're hard to bury, they're hard to work with. And here's a pro tip. If you put a rug underneath it, sink it, and then take the rug out, it disappears. I don't know, it falls off the planet. I don't know, it just vanishes. So don't do that. Got them propped up here. Got a little porch, a little deck area with the chain link fence. I like the chain link fence under there. I don't know why I like that, but I do. There's the door. So here on the left, we have a holding cell and a visiting area. Homeboy has, he's been yes. Bad. So he's kneeling one of those busy settlers mats, the invisible ones. It takes him a long time to get in there and sit down. I don't know why he can't figure out how to get in there, but he can. So you got your camera and some note taking, you know, mugshot, like they distribute pictures or whatever. Cigarette machine, more waiting area, plant. And so here's the judgment area. The prisoner gets the lights in his face or her face, whatever. Handcuffs, they get cigarettes, they get a glass of water, you know, doing their thing. Some decorations here. Here's the whole room. I changed the roof from the previous build. I like the vaulted roof better. So go up here, and then here's where the judgment people sit. They got some books to, I don't know, refer to. Maybe they're law books. Maybe they scrounged them out from somewhere. Those books are a pain in the ass, by the way. I don't like placing them. This will be the only time you'll see these books. Oh my God, such pain. And then here's what the judgment thing is. They got some note taken, more coffee, and of course, security in case the prisoners have to get a little unruly. Assault rifle will take care of that. So that, I think, is pretty much it for this one. It's a very, very, very bare bones kind of thing. It got kind of overbuilt, but yeah, I don't know. I like it. I wasn't really feeling this one. I got to admit, I got to be honest with you. I was not feeling this one at all. It was okay, but it didn't really, nothing really jumped out at me. Nothing really spoke to me. Nothing really sang. It just went, look, I'm a settlement, build on me. I'm like, oh, okay. So let me go over here. We'll give you a really quick night run. I'm not going to spend a lot of time lingering around. See if I can do this the right way. So I'll put it up here. And let's see. All right, I'll be right back. And here it is at night. Again, like all my other ones, it's dark. It's better lit, I think, than the other ones because I got to keep an eye on the prisoners, you know. So their area down there in that little shelter is very, very bright because it's got those bright, bright lights. But the rest of it's pretty dim. It's not too bad. The truck is definitely dark. Everything's dark up here, so he can see what's going on. because that truck down there is dark as well. So we don't want to tip anybody off coming up the road. That innings, of course, that bright red satellite dish out there is probably going to give them a hint that maybe something's going on up here. But I like it. I don't care. I'm keeping it. So outside, of course, dark, dark, dark. Turrets and little stands. Some lights over here to light the prisoners so they can keep an eye on somebody. Anybody makes a break for it, they can the turret will get them. And still working. Hard at work, trying to work off his work off their indentitude.
Lost track of how many blisters I got.
Farming's as honest as honest.
What
work
kind
gets.
Of prisoner abuse going on in here, ladies? What's up with this? Is this kind of freaky shit going on here? You need to knock that off. Or, you know, record it and I'll distribute it for money. Anyway, I doubt they have anything like that in the Commonwealth, but you never know, man. There's all kinds of weird crap going on in here. So, yeah, we'll just look up here. There's the tower. The only place that's really well lit is this part here. And it's pretty dim, so you can see, you know, the readouts. I don't know. They're pretty bright. Outside of this box is very dark. Go in here. Hey, what's
yeah.
up? And see, he walks around because he treats it like ghouls? A job. So he's just kind of...
Isn't that
he kinda,
something?
Hey, Houdini, dude. You couldn't have closed the door behind you. You must have just spawned outside here. Here's the judgment room. And see, that light is really bright on that seat. I was hoping to get lucky when I'm sitting in that seat. Because they do. They'll come in here and sit in all these seats. But no such luck. They're just wandering around. The workshop. My survival stuff. The doctors. Again, not too... no lights on the turrets. We don't want to tip them off the turrets over there. Oh, got to go in here. I like the little round light underneath there. I'm starting to like the round one a little bit better, I think. And, of course, this is very well lit because it's an experimentation area. And there digs in here. Already asleep. The doctor's had a hard day, I guess. And that will be... Oh, let's go to here. I keep forgetting. Well, I got to start writing a list of all the areas so I cannot forget to go in there. But again, it's some reasonable lighting. It's not too bright, not too dark. It, you know, they can sleep. And of course, this is well lit because this is the administrative area there. And go around here. Nice and dark in here. Nice and well lit. And of course, the observation deck up here. Keep an eye on down there. And, oh, he's in this little, he's in the little thing, so excellent. All right, folks, that'll wrap this one up. We're going to be going somewhere else after this. I haven't decided where yet. I think it's probably going to be Hangman's, but again, I'm not getting the feel for Hangman's, man. I don't know why. I might just decorate Taffington, do a tour, and just get that out of the way, or hell, start going at Starlight. I don't know. The pace is going to be slowing down for a little bit because, you know, life and adult responsibilities and all that lovely, lovely crap. So I want to thank you all for watching. And I will see you in the next one. Take care.